Hi, I'm Kathy Russell, and I'm the General Curator here at the Santa Fe College Teaching Zoo. I'm also the SSP Coordinator for Perdido Key Beach Mice. The SSP stands for Species Survival Plan, and we are actually sitting inside our building where we take care of all of our Perdido Key Beach Mice. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about their natural history, as we've got a couple that are out here right now. This particular species is one of eight species of beach mice. There's three that live on the coast on the east side of Florida, and then there's the rest that live in the panhandle. And the Perdido Key lives along Perdido Key, which is part of a key that travels from Florida near Pensacola into Alabama. That's the only place you're going to find these cute little guys. They live in the dune system. They're kind of the best thing for the dunes in that they eat the seeds and the fruits from the plants that live in the dunes, and then they disperse those so more dunes are made. So we kind of consider them the builders of the dunes. They're nocturnal, so you're only going to see them at night if you're even lucky. They also are a little different than the house mouse in that they make a mate for the rest of their life. So they are what's considered monogamous. The SSP, Species Survival Plan, is just that. It's a plan. And in this case, this plan was put together by a few different AZA, which is Association of Zoos and Aquarium, accredited institutions. So on board, we have the Bavard Zoo, we have the West Palm Beach Zoo, we also have ourselves, and we've recently brought on the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C., and they have a few mice there. So together, or collectively, we have put this plan into place. In addition, we have some great partners, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, Florida Wildlife Commission, as well as the Alabama Wildlife Commission. And through their help and their guidance, we've put together this entire plan so that we can have and house a very healthy and genetically healthy population of Perdido Key beach mice. So if something happens, such as a hurricane, and wipes out the majority of the population on Perdido Key, we will have mice available that we can put back out on that key, and after a few years, they'll be able to breed and reproduce and repopulate that area. In addition to maintaining a healthy genetic population, SSPs have another large component, and that has to do with education and conservation. And so one of our roles is we really want to get people excited about these mice. I mean, you sit here and you watch them run around. It's how can you not do something about these little guys? And the more that we can explain what their life is like, how important they are, then people will go out and they'll take a little bit better care of the beaches and the dunes. And so that's our end game, is to make sure that people will conserve that area. If you could conserve the dune system and, you know, these guys' habitat, then you're also conserving sea turtles, you're making areas for the shorebirds to be able to lay their eggs and raise their young. There's so many other species that are involved in the system that these guys put together. Working with this SSP for many years now, and it's because these guys are just a delight to work with. If you watch them, they're moving around really fast. They grab their food, bring it into their burrows. You can see a little bit of a burrow system here and down here. If we clean out their tank and start all over again, they're sitting there digging and digging and digging for their burrows. And the reason why we actually have the sand in here is we try to mimic their natural habitat as much as possible, and they're burrowers. And so if we just have newspaper or something down, that certainly wouldn't help them. So burrowing gives them something to do, and that's where they live, and that's where they have their food caches. You'll see also in here, we've got some height in here. They do like to climb. They like to tear up vegetation. There's a little bit of nesting material in here. What's happened over here is the males will dig out and clean out their burrows. When then they're dirty, they will kick all the bad stuff out of there, which so they help us out in cleaning. We don't actually have to dig out the burrows and clean. The mice do that for themselves. So they're just a fascinating species to watch. When they run on the wheel, that's to get their exercise. We know that there aren't wheels out on the key, but it helps them to get some good exercise, and they seem to really enjoy it. On behalf of myself and some of our Perdido Key beach mice, Peter, Paul, and Mick, we appreciate you taking time to learn about these fascinating, essential dune workers.